What's going on, dudes? My name is Prestige. Thank you so much for joining me on the channel. Today we're going to be playing some uplink on the brand new map Kremlin. This just came with the Supremacy DLC today. I'm playing in the Grapple playlist as well, so I hope you all enjoyed the gameplay. I wanted to have a short discussion about the brand new game update that just came out today for Call of Duty Advanced Warfare with the Supremacy DLC. This update actually buffed two perks, which is something that we've never had before in Call of Duty history, so I'm going to talk a little bit about that. I also want to touch base on the brand new gear sets that came through. We have legendary gear, which added the Sentinel CI gear set, and then we have retired gear, which I want to talk a little bit more about that so you guys can understand it a little bit better. So if you would like to follow along with these updates, make sure to click the link down below in the description. It'll take you to the official community page at callofduty.com, and you can see all of the updates listed out in order, which we're going to speak of. The first thing I want to talk about is in-game updates. So we've had a couple of issues with split screeners playing through, split screeners being able to have their weapon removed and the loadout when starting a match, which is really weird. A split screen player being able to join a lobby and a bunch of weird crash issues. So that was fixed. We had player connectivity issues for online services, and that has been updated for the combat readiness program. And then finally, we get to the flak jacket perk and the hardwired perk. So basically what happens is, if you were running flak jacket, if you got hit with an explosive, you would be protected, of course, but you would still take flinch from explosive damage, and it would cause you to put your weapon up in the air. You wouldn't be able to fire upon your enemy, and that sucks if you're playing domination or momentum where a lot of explosives are bound to be used. So what happens is this perk just got buffed to make it so you will not flinch when taking explosive damage from lethal equipment. That is with flak jacket. So just like flak jacket, hardwired got a similar treatment in which tactical equipment like stuns and EMPs, they won't actually make us flinch if we get hit while using that perk. It's actually really cool. This is something that would affect a lot of people while playing, once again, momentum, domination, or any objective-based mode where a lot of people are piling up together at any given time. Explosives, stuns, EMPs are all bound to be used. So this is actually good. And like I said before, this is the first time in COD history that we got a double perk upgrade or like a double perk buff. We've actually seen a nerf to perks before. If you guys remember back with Call of Duty Modern Warfare 3, there was actually a nerf to sit rep and then there was a buff to sit rep. It was really, really weird, but that's what happened. And then everyone started complaining about it, but it's whatever. The past is the past. Time to move on to the future. So let's talk a little bit about this legendary gear that was added. Legendary is in its own tier. It's actually in a purple tier. You can see this right here in this image. So this legendary armor is actually very unique because what happened was there's only one person in the world, or there was only one person in the world that had this gear, and that was the very first person that reached Grandmaster Prestige on the Xbox One version of Call of Duty Advanced Warfare. After this, legendary gear was added today, and now anybody can get this gear, and it's great. So this is in its own tier altogether. It's even higher than elite gear, and it's even rarer than elite gear. So that's something that's very cool to think of. Now, this is where a lot of people got confused, the retired gear. So the retired gear that's going on today is the MP443 Grok Latitude, the Atlas 45A3, and the PDW-CQB. All three of these weapons are pistols. All three of these weapons are now retired. Now, what does that mean for you as a player? You can still redeem retired items. They're still counted as enlisted items, except if you redeem them and you get rid of them, they will no longer be there forever. They are gone. You will never be able to get them again. They are now classified as super rare. So if you end up getting rid of these items, you'll never be able to get them again for the entirety of Call of Duty Advanced Warfare. So please think before you get rid of a retired item. You can't earn retired items out of advanced supply drops. You can't earn them out of supply drops in general. So that is what a retired item is. It's a weapon that was once able to be gained, and now it's no longer able to be gained, which means it's retired. You're still able to use it like normal, except now people that see that and they don't have that, they won't be able to get it. So that's what a retired item is. Don't be confused with it. Do not delete the item. It's now classified as super rare. It's kind of funny how an enlisted item can go into super rare in the blink of an eye. I think that's cool. Finally, there were some challenge updates. The pincushion and deadeye medals are now awarded correctly when using a crossbow variant, which is something that wasn't working before. There were some game mode specific updates. There was an error message that was added calling invalid surface if you tried to use the grapple on a teammate, which is very weird. It replaced the MK14 weapon with the M1 irons in gun game, which is cool because I like the MK14, but I like the M1 irons a lot more. There was actually some map-specific updates, fix an issue with the enemy system hack while using the super serum on Site 244, improvements for issues near the B domination flag on Site 244, and then fixed various out-of-map exploits across different multiplayer maps. Now, the thing is, I'm still noticing that there's out-of-map glitches. I played Infected today just to see which maps have been fixed, and unfortunately, I still saw people getting out of the map and on top of the map on Solar. I'm not exactly sure how they're doing it. I'm not sure if that place has been patched and then now people already found another place to go up. I just know that it's annoying. It's been there since the launch of the game. I just wish that there'd be a barrier placed there where nobody can jump up, or a death barrier or something, to where if anyone got up there, they would instantly die. Finally, rounding out the updates, there were some exo-zombie updates to fix out-of-map exploits, basically making you invincible, zombies wouldn't be able to get you, and then an issue where a secondary weapon name wouldn't show up after switching from the ohm to shotgun mode and back and forth and etc. So that is it for the updates that came out today. Along with some other things, I just want to mention that the legendary gear that has been added is very, very cool. I want to see them add legendary weapons. Maybe this kind of plays into what Michael Condry was saying before, where we may have a third elite weapon. It's not technically going to be elite anymore. It's going to be legendary. So I'm not exactly sure what to think. I would like to see different variations of weapons come into the legendary tab, but as of right now, there is only one legendary gear set available in Call of Duty Advanced Warfare on the Xbox One and Xbox 360, and it is very, very rare. So if you see anybody with the entirety of this outfit, give them a round of applause. They are the luckiest person in the world. One more thing that I want to mention about legendary gear. If you're playing the Xbox 360, you may have noticed this. I had a lot of you guys sending me images of it. This is actually the Inferno, the BAL-27. For some reason, in-game on the Supremacy DLC, it's showing up as this. And I don't know why it's showing this weapon as a legendary weapon. I think that it's literally just an update error that could be affecting this weapon in particular. I'm not sure if it's affecting any other weapons in particular, but this is literally just an update issue. I do not think that they would make another tier of legendary weapons and make it exactly the same as the elite weapons we already have. We currently have the elite weapon, then we have the royalty counterpart, which is still an elite weapon. I don't think that they would do it one more time with this and then do it over again and again and again. I just don't think that that makes any sense, but this is definitely a cool thing to see. I think that this is a very cool image, but I don't know what is going to happen in the future. Like I said, it would be great to see more legendary weapons added, or actually legendary weapons added in general, to make it different from what we have with elite weapons, the royalty weapons, and things of that nature. So anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you enjoyed the talk about the updates today. If you did, make sure to click that thumbs up button down below, and do not forget to subscribe for more awesome videos each and every day. Until next time, everybody, I am out. Peace!